broadcast is brought to you by the Public Morals Office of the Order of Salvation. Please pray and thank Almighty God for allowing us to see another dawn.
Chocolina! Wait, that doesn't sound right. I have special powers I use to transform into a beautiful human lady.
You're in the right place.
I'll bet you move at lightning speed.
Go ahead and board the train.
Are you taking the train? Don't forget to...
could do with more backup.
That was it. The last creature of its line. In the end, you did just what those diviners said you would.
Guess I should tell them. I don't know if even they believe they've cast a spell on me. But I've put on a show for them this long. Might as well keep it up till it's over. Target acquired. Keep a cool head. As much.
Thank you. trains are running.
Seems that girl Louise really was. Spend your nights in luxury.
Her name was Louise.
So the ones behind this were what a horrible way to go.
Creatures of the dark. There's no place for them in the City of Light.
You look like you're enjoying yourself. Good book?
It's my journal. I've written in it for years. I read through it every day. Reminds me of the past. I'm retired, so I have plenty of time on my hands.
Those are all yours? Every single one?
I've been writing for 500 years now. That adds up, you know. the memories. I've experienced so much in those years. I've really led a great life. Nowadays, I find joy in reading about the past and enjoying freshly baked delicious muffins.
The simple pleasures in life for a simple man.
Absolutely, yeah. Oh, speaking of freshly baked muffins.
Fresh out of the oven, just the way you like them.
Excellent. Thank you very much, young man.
You say that to me every day. Change it up a little, will ya?
Oh, I'll think of something different for you tomorrow. Let me see here. There you go.
Thanks. See ya.
Marlin bakes the most mouth-watering muffins.
That's nice. You two seem like your old friends.
Well, I'd like to think we're more than that. Talking to him always cheers me up. To me, that friendly boy who brings me muffins every day is like the son I never had.
Great memories, great food. Great friends. What more do you need? Looks like you're all set.
Indeed I am. I know we don't have much longer in this world, but even if everything ends tomorrow, I'll have no regrets. Well, except for one little thing. It's about these journals. Well, I'm afraid I lost the first one some time ago. It chronicles the first 50 years of my life. 50 years.
You want it back, of course.
Yes, I do. I don't suppose I could ask.
Sure, why not? I'll take a look. How will I know it's yours?
My name is written on the cover. Oh, and I'd like to ask you not to read it if you find it. Not to say my life has been all that exciting.
Of course. It'll be tricky to find, though. Do you remember where or when you lost it?
Well, it's a bit of a long shot, but I may have donated it with some of my old books by mistake, a long time ago. A woman named Mitka. She runs a secondhand shop, or used to. I'm afraid I don't know where she is now, or what she's doing. Reading that journal again, huh?
You can hold your own.
Thank you for visiting. Do visit anytime.
I saw a woman with rose-colored hair around these parts the other night. She seemed to have been inspecting the crime scene.
A lot of strange rumors are going around. People are whispering about ghosts and ghouls, of being haunted by dead girls. You don't believe them, do you?
I like to keep an open mind. If the stories are true, I'd like to help those people. They died because of me.
As much as I hate to say this, you're not omnipotent. As the savior, you don't have the power to save the dead.
Yeah.
The souls of disbelievers will sink into the chaos.
God watch over all of us.
Choco Loco!
You look like you have troubles.
Well, no, not really. Just lost in my thoughts. Thinking about an old friend.
Oh?
He passed away, unfortunately, a while back.
I'm sorry.
Oh, by the way, my name is Armand. Would you have some time to spare? I have quite a story to tell about him.
Sure. Tell me about him.
He was a reporter. A firm believer that the pen was mightier than the sword. A do-gooder. Believed he could save people by exposing the evils and hypocrisies of society. Naive, maybe, but full of determination.
Being naive's better than having no ideals at all.
Agreed. At first, he was just a regular beat reporter for a local paper. His articles were mainly about the local stores and great discounts they were offering that week. You know, little tidbits to help people out in their daily lives. As you can tell, nothing worthy of the front page. But one day, a great opportunity fell into his lap.
He got assigned a big story.
You're one step ahead of me. But that's enough storytelling for one day. The rest will have to wait for another time.
I was told about a special medicine that only you can make.
Yes. Say no more. Except we're all out. I'm really sorry. I can make more, but I can't get my hands on the ingredient. I wish I could have helped that poor girl.
I'm here for her, actually.
Of course! And I'll do it for free. Here's a list of all the ingredients.
For a woman who used to own a bookstore in these parts?
Well, my name is Mitka, and I ran a bookshop once back in the day.
I'm not, but maybe you can help me. Listen, I know it's been a while, but I was wondering if you remember a man named Ranulf.
Ah, yes, I remember him. Who are you anyway? What do you want with him?
He's the one who found me, really. He asked me to track down an old journal of his for him.
He did? That's a strange request.
Eating muffins and reading his books?
Oh. So, why are you helping him, if you don't mind my asking?
It's what I do, that's all.
Oh. Are you one of those people who does charity work?
Call it what you will. So, can you help me out?
All I can tell you is that I've never handled his journal, but I do know a thing or two about his past. But none of that is for me to divulge. If you want the truth, you need to find out for yourself.
I plan to. I just don't know where to start.
Head to the part of the city they call the Warren. Once there, seek out the man with no name.
Right. Hope there's only one of them, or that's gonna be rather difficult.
Oh, not to worry. You'll find him. What you're doing is admirable, but it might not be what he really needs.
Let's get this over with.
like a cocoon soldier.
Interesting.
What is this?
This broadcast is brought to you by the Public Morals Office of the Order of Salvation. It is now noon. Please pray. Let us devote our working day to the glory of God.
Have your sights on anything?
Come back anytime.
That's right, it'll cure.
Step right up! Thanks as always!
Welcome. Oh, I see. Not everyone knows what this is used for. You must know your stuff. Thank you very much.
You been on a trip down Chaos Lane? Oh, our wealthy client wants you to have this. Things have been good for me. I had a handful of great hunters, but they were all killed by some ugly monster. That's why I'm out here, all by my lonesome.
Everything you need for the medicine.
You managed to get everything on the list? That's incredible! Now give me a few minutes while I work my magic. Here you go! The greatest man-made remedy of all time. I hope this works. What am I saying? I know it'll work.
Something for you.
Is this really what I think it is?
I said you could, didn't I? Now go and take it to your father.
Oh, I will. Thank you. You're one of the good ones. I didn't think there were many of you left. I don't know what to say. I just about lost faith in everyone.
Did you tell people about your situation? If they knew.
I tried, but no one even bothered to hear me out. And it wasn't even about the money. They just didn't want to get involved. I can't blame them for avoiding a poor girl from the Warren. I'd about given up when you came by. You were the only one who bothered to ask if anything was wrong, you know that? I guess there's still a bit of light in this city after all.
Of course there is. It took a while, but you ended up getting what you needed to help your father, didn't you? Even though the world is consumed with darkness, people are still willing to help others. Have some faith.
You're right. So what are you? Some kind of angel sent from the heavens or something? I know the world is ending soon and there's little time to do much else. But I pray the rest of your days are bright and full of bliss for you and your loved ones. And that's the truth.
Will be destroyed.
Do you have any place?
Require a room?
This broadcast is brought to you by the Public Morals Office of the Order of Salvation. It is now midnight. Please pray. Let us thank God, who in his wisdom will build us a new world.
Where did I put my ticket?
To tell me your name.
You only need a name if you want to talk to people.
You're definitely the one I'm looking for. The man without a name. That's you.
It's true. I've been nameless for many years.
I guess we can skip the introductions then. I've got a question for you. The reason I wanted to talk to you is because I'm looking for a journal. It belonged to Ranulf.
Ranulf's journal? Why? What do you want with a thing like that?
Nothing. It's not for me.
I thought this day would come. After 2 centuries, I'd hoped he'd given up. So much water under the bridge.
What did you say?
You say Ranulf asked you to do this for him. Is that true?
That's right. He did.
Then go to Yusnan. A woman named Durin has what you're looking for. When you see her, hand her this letter. Tell her that Reddick sent you.
Reddick?
It was centuries ago. Orin liked to watch the trains go by. You'll probably find her near the overlook in Yusnan, where you can see the tracks. Head to Yusnan.
fixer. My father has made a quick recovery.
Come on, Micah. You know I... Huh? Wait, you're not her.
Ulrich, what do you think you're doing accosting strangers like that? I'm sorry. Forgive him. My son mistook you for our dear Miss Micah.
Right. Easy mistake to make.
Miss Micah is beloved by our god Benevelza. What with the rose-colored hair, some even speculate that she could be the chosen one. The savior.
That's because Micah heard the voice of God. She told me!
The savior with rose-colored hair, huh?
Yes. Dear Miss Micah. She is a wonderful young woman.
We've been waiting ages for her next visit.
Were you expecting her to come again soon?
Uh-huh. And guess what else? She even promised us she would bring a phantom rose for us next time she came.
It's a crimson-colored flower, very similar to a rose. They're said to never wither or die.
Flower that never dies.
You're not easily fooled, are you? Yes, the Phantom Rose is nothing more than a fairy tale told to children. But this is what Micah said when she left. I'll bring you the legendary flower that no one believes can be found. So don't you give up on hope. Keep living. As you can see, I don't have much time left. But when she told me to go on living, I wanted to hold on, just so I wouldn't let her down.
Fake savior lady! If you see the real Micah around, tell her that she better not forget her promise to me.
Okay. Ulrich, who taught you it was okay to be rude to others?
Sure, kid. I'll tell her not to forget about your flower.
Thanks. You're all right for a fake.
Hey, little missy. How about a drink?
Looks like you've already had enough for both of us.
Not by half. You wanna know why? Ask my dearly departed fiance. She left me standing there like a fool at the altar.
Do you really blame her? Who wants to marry a drunkard?
You got it all wrong, honey. I started drinking after she left me. Everything has gone downhill since then. You probably won't believe me when I tell you, but I used to command a whole legion of the Order's finest men. Those days, I was on top of the world.
Then why did your fiancé leave you?
Not even the foggiest. Me and Filiana. We were so in love. Then she disappeared and never came back.
She disappeared out of the blue? Are you sure something didn't happen to her?
Of course I did. From the palace in Jusnan to the edge of the wildland. I searched for decades, but I never even heard a whisper of Filiana. And when I described her, no one had ever even seen her pass through. My Filiana was a looker. No one could have forgotten seeing her. We were the happiest two people could be. I crashed down from heaven to hell. There's no salvation to be found in this world.
And if there's no salvation, then there's no hope.
Can you honestly tell me that I'm wrong? Show me. Show me where there's any hope in this place. What? You're gonna find my Filiana for me and prove me wrong?
I I'd be willing to at least try. If there's still hope in this world, it has to be found. You have to look for it.
Ha! You're a tough chick with a good heart.
I said I was willing to try, and I meant it. Where was the last place you saw what was certainly your better half?
You're actually going to go find her? Filiana and I both lived in Yuznan back in those days. She was a fantastic cook.
Did you check out the restaurants in Yuznan?
Oh, you don't get how desperate I was back then.
I'll go back and check them again.
What? You will? Here, take this with you. Matching rings. Seeing it just reminds me of her.
Strong woman.
You look familiar for some reason.
You and I, we've met before, right here where we stand. Although I really wasn't in any state to introduce myself at that time, I'm afraid.
You're one of the women who was killed by Etro's heretics. It was your resemblance to me that got you killed. It was because of me that you died.
Yes, but I don't blame you. It was my destiny to die here so that I could meet you, Savior.
You're saying God intended for you to die like this?
I believe so. I believe I was meant to die and gain enlightenment. I know because I was a member of the Order and learned all about the teachings of God. I'm to share with you my knowledge and help guide you on your journey. Savior, you must be aware that in this world, new life hasn't been born for hundreds of years. Do you know why that is?
I've never given it much thought, but I suppose that's part of his plan, too. And that's what the Almighty Buenavelza chose as his solution.
No, I'm afraid that's not the case. It wasn't due to his plan. It was because of the goddess's disappearance.
Because of Etro? How?
In this world, Etro is believed to be the goddess of death. Her followers are heretics. Ones who go against society's ways. But the true Etro... she was the goddess that provided new life, with a soul and a spirit.
And now that she's gone, there's no one out there to take her place.
Reincarnation isn't a part of the world's cycle anymore, and that's why no new life is born. This problem, it doesn't just affect our world. According to legend, the Almighty Buenavelza will appear before us one day, and when he does, he will recreate heaven and earth. But that leads to the question, when this happens, who will breathe life into the new world?
That's a good question. With the goddess gone, I suppose someone needs to fill her shoes.
Yes. Otherwise, the circle of life will remain broken. You have a duty as the savior. You have to find a way to do what Etro once did.
That's a hell of a tall order. Finding a replacement for a goddess. but I want to thank you for telling me this, and I won't forget what you told me. You have my word.
That's all I need to hear, to be completely honest. I don't know if you can save us all, but I know that if I have to put my faith in someone, it's you.
What just happened? Was I able to save her soul? But that's not possible.
What was that light? Did you say something?
Hope, you said that the Savior doesn't have the power to... save the souls of the dead. I can save the living. That's it.
That's right. You can save all the living souls you want, but once they're dead, it's too late to help them. What makes you ask? Is there something you want to share?
No, just thinking aloud. Don't worry about it.
The day has finally come when I get to meet the Savior.
Are you... You must be one of the heretic's young victims.
Yes, that's right. But looks can be deceiving. I'm not so young anymore.
I'm sorry. I'm the reason you were killed. It's my fault.
Oh, stop it. Don't look so solemn. It's not like you plunged a knife through my heart. Besides, it was a fitting way for me to go.
How could it be?
When I was alive, the Almighty God Bonavelsa spoke to me. He told me I was to save the souls of those in need. I devoted my entire life to carrying out the plan he had laid out for me.
If what you say is true, that would make you a savior too.
No, it's not like that. It's not like that at all. I wish I was like you, but I'm just a fraud that thought she was chosen by God. After I died, I realized something. It was just an echo in my head that I turned into something else. I know you must think I'm just a big fool, but will you save me, Savior?
You have no idea how much I wish I could. I just don't have the power to save the dead.
What a pair we make. The one who is actually chosen by God and a fraud who thought she was chosen by God, and neither can do a thing. I tried, though. I tried and was never able to save a single soul. At the very least, I wish I could have saved my own.
Those two will never give up on her. And then, at that very moment, her soul shone with a blinding light, and somehow she was saved. It shouldn't have been possible. I don't have the power to save the dead. How could this be? Was God listening? Did he hear her last wish and perform a miracle through his gracious will? Or was it me? Am I more powerful than even God himself knows?
If this continues, people will become...
trust in our god, Bunavero.
Who are you?
You of all people should know who I am. And what happened here? Think about it.
Your hair color. I guess I do know what happened.
That's right. When I was alive, I spent my days as one of God's soldiers, keeping those heretics in line. It wasn't easy, but under the Order's authority, I worked day and night to keep the peace. That's probably why I was targeted.
It was certainly courageous, going against such a dangerous organization.
Rumor has it he's their leader, a renegade rebelling against the established Order. His actions weren't without good reason. In all fairness, we brought it on ourselves. The Elders used their monopoly on food and goods to enforce the law.
Do as we tell you or starve to death.
Of course, when you start reducing food supplies, what happens? Then one day an incident occurred that shocked everyone. Someone stole and redistributed the food reserves to the children of Etro.
A heroic bandit.
Yes. Rumor has it that during his operation, he snuck into the quarters of one of the elders and left a message on their pillow while they were sleeping. The Shadow Hunter will seek justice. The Order got scared and began distributing provisions to everyone again.
It's strange hearing the stories I've missed while I was asleep. So much has happened in the past 500 years that I know nothing about. We never crossed paths when you were still alive, and I can't even begin to imagine what you must have gone through during your lifetime.
I just wanted to pass on my stories before I disappeared forever. Thank you.
Even though their lives were taken from them, they continued to exist in our world. Each one of them still shining brightly, each one of them a single beacon of hope for all of us. Those who still carry on with their lives must never forget these innocent victims. If enough people remember to keep them in their hearts, these girls can live for eternity. Is that what she wanted me to know? Is that what she wanted the world to know?
Again, you're back.
You wouldn't be talking to me like that if you knew what I'd been up to.
You saw Micah? What did she say? When's she gonna come back?
I have some bad news. Micah won't be coming to see you anytime soon. She didn't have much choice in the matter.
But she...
She did give me this, though, to give to you.
Is this what I think it is? A phantom rose? Awesome! Mom, look at this! It's the flower, and it's real!
It really is breathtaking. The petals almost seem to glow. Thank you, miss. Micah kept her promise, so I guess I'd better try to do the same. I may not be long for this world, but then again, the world is nearly out of time itself.
Mom! I told you Micah would keep her promise!
You were right, sweetie. Miss Micah, she really was a savior, wasn't she? Our savior.
The Phantom Rose, a ghostly name for a beautiful blossom that supposedly never withers or dies. Micah wasn't the savior. The only voice of God she heard was in her own head. But even if she was delusional, the hope and promise she provided was real. For those two, she was undeniably the real savior.
Hello, welcome.
Business is good.
It is, thank you. This city is known for its gourmet restaurants, but none can hold a candle to the chefs we have assembled in our kitchens.
The best chefs in the city, huh? Blackley mentioned his missing fiancé was a great cook. I wonder.
Ma'am, is there something I can help you with?
I hope so. I'm looking for someone by the name of Filiana. Does this ring look familiar to you at all?
Oh, yes, yes, of course. The woman was a wonderful cook indeed. Though the strange thing is, I never knew her by the name of Filiana.
She may have assumed another name.
Now, this is taking quite an odd turn. She was no doubt a very handsome woman, but very advanced in age. I suppose she must have been beautiful enough to turn heads once, but she was undeniably an old woman. Of course, we are all old now, that we don't age, but she must have been quite elderly already when...
An old woman? Where is she now?
I'm afraid I don't know. The lady in question fell ill and left our restaurant. I believe she moved to Luxarian to live with the support of an old friend there.
Do you know how to reach her?
Unfortunately, I don't know that woman's name or anything else about her. I saw her only once. She was a young woman, and if I recall correctly, wearing a rather unusual hat. Perhaps she was her daughter.
I see. Thanks for your time. Blackley's ring ended up on the finger of a beautiful but old woman somehow. It's possible Filiana sold the ring. I'm not looking forward to telling Blackley about it, but he deserves the truth. He needs to know.
During the recent performance, all of them...
Maybe if I wait here.
Welcome, everyone, to the Banquet of the Lord. Our own little palace...
Who are you?
You must be Erin. Here, I have a letter for you from Reddick.
Reddick? Well, that's a name from the past. Let me see that thing. Well, that's his handwriting, all right. I'd recognize it anywhere. Here, I've kept the journal with me, just as I promised him.
I don't mean to pry, but how do you two know each other?
We used to date. Not one of my finer moments, that's for sure. But that was lifetimes ago. He made me keep this while we were still together.
Why would he give it to you instead of keeping it?
The thought never even crossed my mind. And I knew anything that bastard Reddick was involved with couldn't be good. Please, take it. I'm just happy to wash my hands of the whole thing.
All right, I get it. Thanks.
Light, you found his journal. I can't believe it.
I know, right? Weird, huh? What I don't understand is why there are so many people involved. Then he gave it to his friend Orin, for safekeeping.
I wonder if it holds some sort of big secret. A secret so dangerous, just having the journal in his possession could put him at risk. What do you think?
I think I should read the journal before I give it back.
It would be the fastest way to find out what's going on.
But does it really matter at this point? I mean, we're already neck deep in his affairs, it's all...
Okay, it's up to you.
I need to know the truth.
Day 2505. I searched every inch of Yusnan. I found no clues as to who killed my wife and child. Day 3229. I came across a merchant in the Warren who had a valuable piece of information about the case. A certain business rival wanted me out of business. Was this his doing? Did he kill my family to make some sort of sick point? Day 4762. I can't stop picturing my daughter's corpse. I can't erase the image from my head. I have nothing to live for anymore. But I can't rest until I find justice. My family deserves it. Day 15756. Revenge is imminent. Mark my words, justice will be served. Day 15757. Justice will be served. Day 15758. Justice will be served. Day 15759. Justice will be served. Day 15760. Justice will be served. Justice will be served. Justice will be served. Justice.
This is... I can't believe Renulf had to live through this kind of tragedy.
His wife and child were killed by a business rival.
The journal begins from the day after the incident and goes on for years. I mean, look at the dates.
He must have been chasing the killer for decades.
But wait, there must be a mistake. Remember what Renulf said before? He told us that he had never had a family of his own.
I don't think he was lying. I think that's what he honestly believes. I think he truly doesn't remember what happened. Look at these journal entries, the same words written over and over. He couldn't deal with reality. He must have cracked, lost his sanity.
Yeah, and with it, all his memories.
In the end, it was the only way he could survive. He doesn't mourn his family, because he doesn't know they ever existed.
This can't be happening! I don't like this.
not the savior again.
Should know your limit.
Excuse me, but who are you? And how is it you know Lackley?
I don't know him too well, but he asked me to find his lost fiance.
About Filiana? But where did...
At a restaurant in Yusnan. Apparently, there was an old woman working there who wore the same ring that Lackley gave to his fiance. And when her health failed, that woman went to stay with a friend who lived in... Huh.
What is it? Is there something wrong with my hat?
According to the man I talked to at the restaurant, the friend who came to pick up the elderly lady was wearing an unusual hat. You seem familiar enough with Lackley. You also knew Filiana's name. Was it you?
Let me explain. Lackley and Filiana and I are friends from long ago. I'm Sila, and yes, I'm the one who escorted that old woman from the shop in Yusnan.
Care to tell me why?
Sure, but can we go elsewhere? There's a graveyard with no name. You know of it, don't you? It's beyond North Station, on the outskirts of town. Oh, good. He's still sleeping.
It's almost time for you to return to the Ark.
Thanks for coming. Before I tell you anything, can you promise you won't pass this information on to Lackley?
That depends on what you have to say.
I suppose that's fair enough. I hardly know where to begin, though.
How about I start, then? The old woman working at that restaurant in Yusnan had the same ring as Lackley's, the same as his fiance's.
For the most obvious reason, of course. That old woman was none other than Filiana. After she left him, she began working under a fake name.
That's surprising. The way Lackley described her. Well, she's not what I expected.
He wasn't lying. She was a real beauty, once. We don't know how or why, but something happened to her. In this world where everyone stopped aging, she was the one and only person who managed to grow old over the past years. It began right around the time she and Lackley first got engaged.
But why? Why would it be possible for one person alone to escape the stasis in this world? And are you saying that's why she left Lackley and disappeared from his life?
She said the last thing she wanted to do was become a burden to him. But I know she missed him. She always wanted to know how he was doing. She loved nothing more than hearing stories about him, no matter how banal they were. Back when she could still walk, she told me how she would sometimes pass by him in the streets. She never said anything to him, and he never could have guessed that the old woman he saw was his beloved fiancée.
That's why he never found her after all this time. No.
Yes. Year after year, she aged more and more, and her body began at last to fail. She's free from that pain now. Finally.
I see. I'm glad she was able to find peace.
No!
No. Lackley!
I wouldn't have cared how old my Filiana looked! I loved her with every fiber of my being! My only wish was to spend every day with her until the end of the world! Filiana, why did you have to... No!
Lackley.
Lackley.
Sela, I don't want you to worry about me. Remember what you told me before, when we met? If there's still hope in this world, maybe I'll find Filiana, right?
Yeah, I remember saying that. So now I've just proven there's no hope.
No, that's not what I'm saying at all. I'm saying I need to find my own hope for me. I can't wait around for any god or savior. And even if my hopes get dashed, or they never come true, at least in my heart I'll know she's watching over me from somewhere. I'm done being a fool who runs to the bottle every time something goes wrong. I want to show Filiana, wherever she is, that I'm still the man she fell in love with. The man I used to be. Could you give me that ring?
Here. Thank you. You've helped me find some hope of my own, while I was supposed to be looking for yours.
I just came to visit my Filiana for a while.
Require a room?
Sacred Tree of Light.
Good to see you again.